I'm Jay.Crafton, and welcome to Naptown City Limits. I'm sitting here with the bad boys of Boogie Blues, the Bangkok Rooster Band. We recorded them live down at the Slippery Noodle Inn. So we're going to go ahead and go down there, and we'll take a look at them. This is the first of two parts. Next week we'll have the second part because I like everything they did. But I have my special reasons, which you'll find out later. It's a fingers thingy. So we'll see you in just a few minutes. Here's the Bangkok.
A young boy at the age of five. My mama told me, son, be the baddest motherfucker alive. Now I'm a man, way past 21. I'm gonna take you all, baby, have all kinds of fun. Cause I'm a man, I spell M A Kansas too. Yeah, I'm gonna pick up my second cousin. That's a homeboy cockaroo. Ah, oh, you young girl, standing there in line. Let me make love you, baby, in an hour's time. Cause I'm a man. I spell him. When I make love to a woman, you know she can't resist. Cause I'm a man, I'm a rolling stone. Cause I'm a man, I'm a natural born lover man. Cause I'm a man, oh let me be a hoochie coochie man. I spell him, exist anymore. Yeah, I said it's over. You don't exist anymore. Now when I had money, you called me honey, and you always wanted me around. But then bad luck hit me. It's a tune called Baby Please Come Home. Well, I've been waiting on you. What you gonna do? Well, I've been waiting on you. What you gonna do? I'm sitting by the phone. I'm tired of being alone. I didn't mean what I said. Talking Oh, baby, please come home. Thank you. Thanks for coming out, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Yagi, could we get just a little... Could I get a little more monitor? Oh, is that the monitor? I love that shirt, man. Love your shirt. How can you wear from that? We'll edit that out on a videotape.
Well, that's right. American Cablevision is here tonight.
Uh-huh.
Taping.
We need extra applause. And
so can we edit that out?
Laughter.
Act like you really like what we're doing up here tonight.
That's right. Just make believe.
Now those monitors sound good now. We're going to do a little Bangkok original here. Come on in, folks. People looking in the window, come on in. We're going to do a little Bangkok original thing called No Smoke Blues here. Understand, show their sympathy. I said to beer cans, they understand, and I have the deepest sympathy. Well, they know this is one thing to really comfort me. I got to know. Looked in all my ashtrays, they'd already been picked damn clean. And then I rifled through my stash box, finding a goddamn seed. Well, I blackmailed my own mother for just a taste of that sweet weed. I got no smoke blues, and thing I would do, I got the no.
I think they know the words out there, Joe.
Hey, Mr. Texas, so how about you? Thank you. So no smoke blues.
Okay. Now do I go ahead and do the interview? Hi, Jeff. How the hell are you?
Hey, Jay. Thanks for having us on here.
Okay. So that everybody knows, we'll go down the line. Who is everybody? I keep wanting to call you Dwayne, but I found out your name is Paul. Okay.
Paul.
Okay. And then we got Dudley. Say hi,
That's
Dudley.
That's right. Hi, Dudley.
And then we've got Jeff.
Jeffrey.
Brian.
You got it.
What the hell is your name?
Dan.
Dan.
Today it is.
Dangerous Dan.
Dangerous Dan. Now there's a good name.
Okay, now I got an axe to grind with you guys.
Uh-oh.
A few years ago, I tried out for this band, and but I don't think you were even with them then. They had...
It might have been the audition that I was...
Yeah, I don't think you... Yeah, maybe they hired you anyway. They had this big audition thing, and I showed up in the ad, so, you know, for a blues band, and I showed up, and they have this guy that's doing all these things, and he has this machine that does fiendish things, and I've got, like, I got an amplifier and a guitar. So, you know, I figured it would just be proper that since, say, you guys didn't put me in a band for it, so I can put you on my TV show.
It was your SAT scores. There were two.
That was it. It was the SAT scores. That's it. But after seeing Paul play, though, it's like, you know, ain't no way. I wouldn't even want to be on the same stage with this guy. So how do you handle it?
How do I handle it? Well, I just handle it in stride, I guess.
Well, I know you guys, you're playing.
Kind of swap back and forth.
Well, you're playing complements each other, but it's a lot different now.
Right. Yeah.
Who are some of your influences?
I haven't been influenced by blues. It's been mostly alternative music, but this has kind of been a little branch, and it's really kind of stretched my music abilities too.
Yeah, Brian's been real kind to us, just to grace us with his presence
right,
and play with
right.
us.
He's, they pay
really
me good,
appreciate
so,
that, Brian.
Yeah.
Do they pay you good? They don't pay me very
really?
Good.
You know, Brian is definitely the best guitarist in his price range.
That's
true.
That we've been able to find
thousands
so far.
Thousands of dollars.
So,
yeah.
So now, Paul, I asked him about his influences. I have to do the same thing. I mean, this is two guitar player band, so what's
well, there's a lot of them. But I think when I heard the Andy Griffith Show, that was it.
Cooper or Gomer? Which one did it for you?
Andy.
Well, I've always been influenced by blues, actually. My mom. I was always playing Jimmy Reed records and stuff when I was little, and Stevie Ray Vaughan was a big influence on me. But I think what happened was I was listening to an Iron Maiden tape one day and took the tape out, and on the radio, you know, the intro to Pride and Joy, I said, man, that's it right there. That's what I got to do, you know. So I think he was a major influence on me. And
God, I'm so moved.
And then, of course, Dudley would have to be a major influence on you.
Yeah, his whole lifestyle, just good, clean living. It's where it's at, as far as Dudley's concerned.
Now, Jeff, your band is pretty. You guys have a pretty diverse background for what you play.
Your band.
And there's it's all you guys' band. But let's face it, Jeff's the leader. I mean, you know, he was there when none of the rest of you were when
he's
I went.
He's got the tie.
He's the only jerk.
I'm the band's accountant. So.
But does it bother you that people classify you guys just specifically as a blues band, and then when they see you, you're everything pretty much but?
Actually, we do on occasion have a little trouble with that, in that we're not solely a blues band. We do a good lot of blues material. We do blues, I like to think that we do blues with a little harder edge than a lot of people do. But we also do some rockabilly. We do some 60s material. We do a lot of Hendrix type of thing. And occasionally folks will get a little teed off about that that comes specifically to hear only blues. And in fact, Dudley, I think we have kind of a message for those folks too, don't we?
Hey, remember, this is family TV.
We had a
it's
show.
A family message.
For all you family.
Okay.
We had a show the other night at the Slippery Noodle where a gentleman got kind of upset because we strayed from the blues. And it is a blues club, and we do a lot of blues, but we don't limit ourselves to that. And rock and roll is based on the blues largely. And we
Bluesy had a baby, named it Rock and Roll.
That's right. So for all of you out there
that was deep.
it is getting deep.
We're in very deep, man.
Okay, now go ahead. Let the man finish. I mean, we're in
so if they don't like it, what?
Bite me. Bite my weenie. That's all I have to say.
Okay.
Cheap hot dog.
I've gotten that out of my system.
I'm not
I feel.
Sure. I think bite me will
I think
make it
work.
I feel a lot better about it though.
So
thanks for giving me
the
opportunity.
Up there with
I knew it, chick.
Okay, so how we doing on time for this? Are we fine? I keep going? Yeah. Oh, well, just
keep
fantastic.
Just keep rapping, Jay.
Okay, yeah, I guess it will. So, now, Dudley.
Uh-oh.
Does it, like, because in the show that we just watched, Of course, you guys didn't watch it, but it's going to be the first one.
It was great, wasn't it?
Let's see, you're trying to sing a song, and Jeff is like, you know, playing with your hair and all kinds
They're
of
homosexual
things.
They're homosexual
lovers. Does it
can't you tell?
I thought maybe you guys were like twins
sit
separated
next to each other.
Actually, Dudley's wife is my boss.
Is he really your boss?
She's Dudley's boss.
It's a woman.
Dudley's boss.
His wife is actually a woman.
Yeah, it is.
Hard to believe. She's a very attractive, nice, fabulous boss, and I love her.
And he's looking for a raise. Look at
this. That's right. Kissing up.
Well, anyway, back to what I was going to say. When you're on stage, it's like everybody has their own thing to do, and you're pretty much the guy that... You know, Jeff will introduce the songs, but you're the guy that, like, ties everything together in between and everything. Did you come to this part? Is this, like, a natural part?
Yeah, it's
that
previous
you
Boy Scout experience.
Is that it?
Knots and doing, I'm not sure what the hell you mean
because,
by that.
Well, I mean, you know, you do a real good job as far as, like, Jeff will introduce a song. And, you know, I'm guilty of it, too. Well, when I played out, I was. You know, where you'd say, well, we're going to do such and such a song. And then you turn around to do it. And you kind of like, you're the color man at a football game or something. You know, you've always got something going. And then when you're being the straight man, then he's doing the color commentary. Is this something that you guys worked out or it just comes naturally?
Yeah, we kind of sit and we plan our act. For hours, hours and hours.
Oh, yeah, I can see that.
We videotape ourselves.
Now, do you test market it in places like, let's say, Greenwood? And
we usually go to Muncie because that is mid-America. But, I don't know. We just have a good time when we play. That's all. We get up. I have a good time. I don't know what the hell he's doing, and he doesn't know what the hell I'm doing, and I don't think it matters. And if people enjoy it, then I guess that's okay. We enjoy it, and if they do, that makes it even better. We have a good time.
Well, Dudley kind of brings the group together, too, being the oldest member of the group.
He's kind of the father figure.
He's kind of the father.
In fact,
he helps us out.
He's more the grandfather of the group, really. I like to think of it.
Actually, when I first talked to him the first time, I think it was on the phone, when he called, I was expecting a much older man than what he is, you know, because you hear this
They don't
voice.
Get much older than that.
Dudley's not
dead.
That's because, like, the first time I see him, I was like, who the heck is this? And then he talked, and he's like, oh, I know who that is. But it was kind of a shock first time I saw him. I've been on this too long. Now we'll go to you.
Oh.
Understand, like, you are into kind of like the jazz thing in your
I listen to a lot of jazz. When I don't have to listen to this band, then I listen to the to jazz influences. I don't really play that much jazz, but that's what I enjoy listening to the most, and that's probably influenced my playing, although basically I'm just a real straightforward drummer and try not to get too fancy.
You can't.
Yeah.
Dan is a power drummer, for sure. Yes.
Well, the one thing that impressed me about him, I didn't hear too many blickums at your show, you know, the blickum, blickum, blickum. didn't hear a whole lot of blickums. That impresses me when I hear a drummer, and they don't do too many blickums.
I don't think blickums is on my list of rudiments.
you're not a blickum
but
person.
But it may be there.
Okay. Now, I'll save you for last, because you play the harmonica, or the harp, as they call it in blues. You know, for you hillbilly people out there, it is a harmonica. I'm going to get letters for that.
But it's also called the mouth organ.
It's the mouth organ.
Jeff's favorite name.
Oh, God, this is going to be fun editing this.
That's why they call us the bad boys.
That's right.
Well, that's it. Do you have any special influences as far as when you learn how to play? Because it's like, I heard a little bit of Little Walter. In your playing,
I like to listen to Jimmy Reed a lot, and like the way that he plays, and Sonny Boy Williamson. I like those styles. I'm kind of a hack at harmonica playing. I just do whatever I can. But
isn't it true that you started playing the harmonica because you didn't want to carry a drum set?
That's exactly true. That is the big benefit of harmonica playing, is that while these guys are lugging their big huge amps and everything, I've got a nice little box here, and that's it. So.
Cool.
Okay, so no smoke blues. Brian Buckwheat is going to do a little thing called Pride and Joy. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Thank you. like a woman should. When we go out, have a lot of fun, yeah. Stay with me, darling, till the evening comes. That's why you're mine.
And we had a civilization that was quite unique in it.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.